Hairspray was something of a surprise, and the sort of explosion of joy that it triggered at the time was sort of magical. And since then, I've always wanted to bring it back, but I wasn't prepared to do it again without Michael Ball, because occasionally there are parts and actors that become so entirely intertwined that you can't really imagine seeing the show without them.
You do well. Will you welcome our new Tracy Turnblad, Miss Lizzie Bea? So Lizzie,
yes.
How are you feeling?
Take this off. Nervous, yeah. But very excited. Today, feeling the way I always do. Oh, 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 hungry for something that I can't eat. Then I hear that beat, that rhythm of town starts calling me down. It's like a message from high above. Oh, 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 pulling me out to the smiles and the streets that I love. Good morning, Baltimore.
To put it in the social context of this, the year is 1962, the year I was born. White and black kids can't dance together mm-hmm. on stage. Mm-hmm. Girls who look like Tracy can't dance with the nicest kids in town. Do you think it's still appropriate now that we talk about these things?
Absolutely, because it shows, I mean, the 60s is not that long ago.
Oh, was that?
Right? There we go. It was quite long ago. it was a long, you know, it wasn't that long ago. And in such a short time, we have come so far. Not only was it commonplace to be racist, to not tolerate integration of any kind, it now is entirely inappropriate. The age we're living in now, you know, it's entirely inappropriate. So in such a short space of time, we've come so far.
Yeah. And yet it still happens. Yeah. We still, you know, on football pitches around yeah. the country, you still have this yeah. kind of appalling racism yeah. going on. So a message that needs to be, people need to be reminded about what happened and reminded there are still steps.
Absolutely, if we can get some of those football fans to come and see the show.
It's a great
That's
idea.
A great idea.
Paul Merton Rita Simions. Hello, Paul. look like a couple.
Yes, we are. I can see why I married you.
Oh. Yeah. I mean, be honest. Be honest.
Although our child looks nothing like either one of us. A
couple of pints, you would.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, this is your first musical.
First musical, yes. I was in a pantomime at Wimbledon Theatre a couple of Christmases ago, which had music in it. And I've already met the choreographer, and I've told him this is a professional challenge which he won't be able to meet, because I am one of those people who can't dance. Not only am I not aware of what I should be doing, I'm also aware of not when I should be doing it. So I mean, it's. But anyway, he said it's walking to music for my part, so I'm reasonably happy about that. I'm genuinely excited as well to be playing a small part, but even an important part in this big machine, which is a West End musical with sort of Broadway directors and stuff. It is something I never would have thought I'd be doing, and I'm thrilled to be part of it. I really am.
Well, it's brilliant that you are. It's
Thank
brilliant.
You.
And you will have the time of your life.
I'm sure I will.
All
Thank you.
So is this a role that you've always wanted to do? Is it and the time is right?
Yes. I actually played a dynamite in a dinner theater version of Hairspray when I was 21 years old. And I understudied Motormouth.
You must have been about 12.
I was about 12. I was so young, but I was like, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do that. I never went on. And then 10 years later, here I am. Well, it's like, well, 14 years later now. Here I am, and I'm playing the role. And I think it's like the right time. It's like perfect.
It absolutely feels.
Yeah.
There's a light in the darkness, though the night is black as my skin. There's a light burning bright, showing me the way. But I know where I've been. There's a cry in the distance. There's a voice that comes from deep within. There's a cry asking why. I pray the answer's above. I know where I've been. There's a road we've been traveling, lost so many along the way. But the riches will be plenty. There's a struggle that we have yet to win. But there's pride in my heart, 'cause I know where I'm going. Yes, I do. And I know where I've been. There's a road we must travel. But there's pride in my heart to lift up.
Two!